Good on you, Samira. Let's talk about this. Almost 1 in 10 of the cigarettes consumed in Europe last year were illegal. That's 48 billion cigarettes and over $10 billion in lost tax revenue. Well, the figures came from KPMG, who were commissioned by the UK's RUSI think tank to look into the issue. So, I guess the question could be, what can be done to reduce demand for illicit products across the globe? Let's find out more. Kathy Henline is research fellow at RUSI, who commissioned the research. Kathy, great to have you with us. 48 billion cigarettes. That's a lot of cigarettes, a lot of lost revenue. It's a big problem. Because we're only talking about Europe here, so how does that play across the EU or Europe in general?
Sure, yeah. I mean, there are obviously variations. It's not a uniform problem across Europe. And we've identified 5 countries that actually stand out as real hotspots for illicit trade in cigarettes. They accounted for over 62% of illicit cigarette consumption in 2016. And the UK is one of those countries. In the UK, we're
in the top 5?
It's in the top 5. And we're talking about 1 in every 7 cigarettes consumed in the UK being illegal.
Is just part of that, is that because of the high, I mean, it's quite costly to buy a packet of cigarettes. I mean, is it because of the tax on cigarettes that is pushing, I guess, the consumer to look for dodgy cigarettes? I don't know.
Well, there's obviously an incentive for the consumer if you're having a hard time financially, if you can access cigarettes for a cheaper price. And I think there is sustained consumer demand for these kinds of illicit cigarettes. But the problem, I think, is that many consumers see this as a victimless crime. They're not aware of the links to organized crime, and they don't see this as having any consequences. But in fact, you know, a lot of this trade is dominated by organized crime groups, and we need to raise awareness of that amongst consumers.
So, and that's really interesting, because I'm just wondering, is it fair to say for these organized crime groups that it is big returns, if you will, they make good money from this with, as you just, low risk?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, there are big incentives for organized crime groups to get into this kind of illegal activity because, as you say, the risks are very low relative to kinds of organized crime like drug trafficking, human trafficking, arms trafficking. If you look at the penalties associated with illicit cigarette trade, they're very much lower, while the profits associated with the trade can be just as significant as those associated with other forms of crime.
And I'm wondering, you know, given that what we just said, what, I think it's $10.2 billion in lost revenue that would go into the coffers of some countries, much needed tax revenue. I'm wondering, why aren't European governments, leaders doing more about it?
Well, we are seeing some successes. In 2016, we saw a number of significant seizures of illicit cigarettes in various parts of Europe. There have been efforts to step up enforcement at key borders and in key illicit trade hotspots. And we've also seen a number of illicit cigarette factories actually uncovered within Europe. And those factories have been actually manufacturing illicit cigarettes and supplying them to consumers across the EU. But obviously, given the figures, that's not really tackling the entirety of the trade. And I think one of the findings of our research is that there are a number of key enablers that we haven't yet effectively addressed. One is the ability of these groups to use the internet to communicate directly with consumers. Similarly, postal and courier services, also the ability to exploit free trade zones where regulations are much weaker. These are all facilitators of the trade that we haven't yet found a solution to.
Okay. Kathy, we appreciate your time. Thanks for coming in. Kathy Henline from RUSI joining us there.